Alright, here we are for the fourth part of the PX-04 Ultimate Mode for the Ultra Magnus City Commander set. Alright, here we have the Knight, also known as Garboil, in his Bird Mode. I'm going to show you how to take him into Jet Mode. I hear a sound above my head. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the little bomb missiles off his wings. Alright, then we're going to do what we did in the sun video, if you saw that. If you didn't, then pay attention. On the neck we have these two notches, and on the little missile bombs we've got two little pegs, and you just kind of fit both of them on the neck for storage in jet mode. You fold the entire head underneath, but this time you don't slide it in, because right here we've got the little cockpit, I guess. So, I mean, it's kind of a weird cockpit, but this is kind of a weird jet mode. You fold up the feet so that it's a... Oh, goodness. Hold on. There we go. Fold up the feet so that it's back in the peg. Alright, what you're going to do is you're going to take these wings, the bird wings, kind of fold them like this, and then you're going to fold them back like this. Alright, and then the bottom part of this little silver piece just folds up, but the top one snaps in. It's got a little peg, so it just snaps in. Make sure that's in there securely. Do the same on the other side, put that under. Snap this one in, and I don't really see a jet out of this, but it's a jet, apparently. So here you go, you've got your jet mode, and one really nice thing about it is that right here in this backside, they've got some really nice paint apps for a thruster. It had to have been really hard to get in there and do that just because of how deep it is. These all sound so terrible as I'm saying them. But that's the jet mode. With the jet mode, you can put the little fire piece in here for like a fire trail, you know, across the sky, whatever. But jet mode, kinda silly. It's basically just like a halfway point between the bird and the weapon mode. And we're going to go ahead and continue on to weapon mode. So all you really do is you flip the feet out, just so that you can push the cockpit in without losing all the missiles. Fold that back up. Take the wings, fold them forward, and they snap together in the front. That is your weapon mode. It says it's a missile. I was under the impression that it was a flamethrower, but I don't know. Either work for me, I suppose. I prefer flamethrower since the flames are going to be moving forward when I place them on Ultra Magnus. Alright, so here we are with Ultra Magnus, already equipped with ejector and rewinder. As well as his backpack, for that matter. Now, if you remember, at the beginning of the Sun video, you saw when it was packaged that they each came with one of these little clips right here. Now, I don't know how they compare to the TAW God Swords. I didn't get them, but they are also from Perfect Effect, and they also had arm clips that worked the same way. But I'm not sure if they're exactly the same. So what you're going to do with these, you're going to take one of them, and you're going to, see if I can remember this, going to take the side that has the, comes further out, and it's going to going to go on the bottom of the arm, I'm gonna go ahead and put the top one on first. No, wait. Put the bottom one on first. And you just kind of slide the top one on. Is that right? Goodness. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just take that off. Okay, well, that was awesome. Alright, there we go. Now he's got an arm clip. Allows him to hold weapons on the side of his arms. Just go ahead and do the same on the other side with the other clip. Just kind of snaps on there, apparently. Wish I would have known that before. Anyways, so those are the arm clips. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your son and your knight, and you can place them in either of the arm clips. Doesn't matter. They fit in both of them. They also each have two peg holes for weapons. So just go ahead and place one on one arm and the other one on the other arm. And I suppose technically you could just snap them in there with the flames facing the other way so they're more like missiles, but I prefer this, and that's what the box shows too anyways. So straighten them out. But in essence, this is all of Ultimate Mode for the most part. These are the only perfect effect weapons that Ultra Magnus has so far. That's not true. There's Ninja as well, which is just a pink version of Ejector and Rewind. But here you have it. This is Ultimate Mode in its entirety. Not much else to say. It's a pretty good set. I like it a lot. Mostly because I like these guys. Which also means we're getting repaints for Buzzsaw and Laserbeak at some point. And I've always been a bigger fan of the Decepticon cassettes. The Audicons, as I call them. But yeah, if you've liked the Perfect Effect weapons, definitely pick it up with, you know, don't hesitate, it's great. If you don't, I think both of these molds are better than the Shadow Warrior, and all of them are definitely better than the King Bat, so, I guess give them a try. We all know that if you were paying attention to the prototype photos of the Condor mold, that they looked kinda, you know, iffy, but they turned out great. The only downside is that they're really huge. But they've got wonderful paint applications, all of them. The only thing I would have liked to change are these little flame swords right here. Aren't actually swords. They only fit in these weapons, and you can't put them anywhere else, really. But other than that, I am pretty satisfied with this. Glad I got it. And I recommend it to any of you. So that concludes the PX-04 Ultimate Form review. See ya.
Ridiculous when they gave you four of the same exact gun, so shut your mouth.